That's what my island is. It's absolute paradise. We got a lot of today. Our good lady Bex has gone through all the Gamescom stuff and found us all the best of the best trailers. And apparently some of them are really fucking good. I'm seeing a Dune game on here. A Dune game? A Monkey Island is mentioned here. Something called Word Song from the Fallout devs. Oh. And something from the same guys who made Detroit Become Human. Which could be interesting. So we're going to say it was a Snorefest. Well, let's take a look at what they've got. I think that's a good idea. Let's see what's going on over here. Because there's always diamonds in the rough. Always diamonds in the rough. I think I have to check the Dune trailer first. I want to see the Dune trailer. I like a bit of Dune. Me likes Dune. Me likes Dune. Dune is very nice. Very nice. Here's the Mind Killer, baby. Certainly is. Got no sound? What? Audio? What? Huh? 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 Fixed. I fixed it. Relax. Relax.
I must not fear. Fear is the mind killer.
Oh no.
Fear is the little death that brings total obliteration.
Are you going to allow it to pass over you and through? You see, this is a health and safety risk. This is not how things work on Arrakis, okay? There should have been a carrier here minutes ago that airlifted this away. This is not what would happen, okay? Absolutely not. This is against health and safety. It's bad regulations. This is not what happens on Arrakis. This is shocking. Shocking. And if you're Paul Atreides, you should be very sad.
I will face my fear. I will permit it to pass over and through me.
Good job. Good job.
And when it has gone past, I will turn the inner eye to see its path. For the fear of God, there will be nothing.
Okay, this trailer is actually really annoying me. None of this would happen in the world of... It's Chris! Go on. Are you in bed? All right. See you soon. Up all night. Couldn't sleep. Overslept. Anyway, yeah, this trailer really annoys me. Okay. First of all, like, genuinely, this would not happen. Or if it did happen, there would be a disaster that led to this. Which is both bogus and sad that they put this in the trailer. It's like you never read the books or anything. And then whoever this character is would not utilize... unless you're a Fremen. Oh, okay, I could be wrong here. I could be wrong. Are you a Fremen and you're trying to bring down... You could be fine.
I will face my fear.
And if you are a Fremen, why are you calling
that? I will permit it to pass over and through me.
A Fremen wouldn't recite that prayer, though. That's a Bene Gesserit prayer. I'm curious.
It's gone past. I will turn the inner eye to see its path. But if fear is gone, there will be nothing. Only only I will remain.
Dunce. It doesn't look like it says dunce. I don't get what this trailer is. If this is a Fremen, he wouldn't be reciting that prayer.
Yo, yo, yo.
And if it is an Atreides, I mean, you have to imagine. Is there a bit more? Okay, okay. It's an MMO? What? It's an MMO? Nopes! Nopes! Woohoo! Nopes! What? What? Get game. Make game appear on my screen. Make Dune MMO appear. Make that happen. Where's the install button? Clicky. Clicky clicks. Make game appear. Hello? Woohoo! Make game happen. You think it's vaporware? Oh, the movie industry's involved in it? Interesting. I don't know. Well, yeah, we'll have to see. We'll have to see. I don't know. If this is supposed to be Paul, this trailer makes no sense whatsoever. Nonsense. It's absolute nonsense. If this is just supposed to be generic, I wonder if you play as the Fremen. An MMO from the perspective of the Fremen would be kind of interesting. If it's after, I wonder when it's set, because they're still mining the spice, so it's during the first book. God, I've got to remember my history here. By God Emperor, they've stopped mining spice, right? Because only Paul's son produces spice. And all the worms are dead. Correct? Am I correct? There's a lot of books. I think it's by God Emperor that stopped happening. That they've killed everything. Just before Atreides arrive? It would be an MMO from the perspective of under Harkonnen rule. That would actually be kind of really interesting. Because there's some really good story events they could put into the MMO that would back that up. If the game starts under Harkonnen rule, that would be really kind of cool. With a lot of brutality and stuff. And then we get like... you can imagine Expansion 1 would be the arrival of the Atreides or something like that. Spoilers? I mean, let me double check this. I believe it's 1984. Double check. I think it's 1984, right? 1965. 1965. Okay, so just to be clear, the Dune novel was released in 1965, and there has been no less than at least two major motion pictures and a slew of miniseries about this. If you had any interest, you would not be spoiled. A4's the film. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking of. I would kind of be down with that, and a little, unless it's like a gacha fucking snack all your money game, which I hope it's not. An MMO on Arrakis as a Fremen based during Harkonnen rule or just as the Atreides are arriving would be pretty good. Sounds boring. What? How does that sound boring? What the fuck? Because you don't like Dune or what? That does not sound boring. The Harkonnen rule over Arrakis was a very big deal. Survival MMO. Depends what that means. Like, survival makes me think of desert living. So if we have to, as a community... build up sieges and things like that. That would be kind of cool. That would be really interesting. I think so. But I'm a big fan of Dune, so maybe I'm a bit biased that way. But if we had to build up our sieges and our water traps and we had to get Chris knives from fallen worms and stuff and ride the worms across the world. It's not about drinking piss. Okay? Still suits filter it, so pure water. Why do you want Bear Grylls MMO? That's what you're asking for? You want the Bear Grylls MMO experience? We're all drinking piss and fucking eating cockroaches and grubs and shit like that. You know what I mean? It's still drinking piss. It's, well, you also drink your shit, so we've got to bear that in mind as well. Guess it's the time to read the Dune and watch the movies. In my honest opinion, reading the book is the reason Dune has been remade so many times, and everybody's kind of open about this. It's not a secret or anything. The reason they've tried to make Dune into something that fits the screen so many times is the book is so complex and has so much subtlety and has so much perspectives of inner thoughts as things are happening that they've really been struggling to put it on a screen. I'm not a big fan of the Denis Villeneuve version because, for me, I think the Denis Villeneuve version 100% assumes you've read the book because there's a lot missing. It's a kind of coherent story, but it really does assume you've read the book or you know kind of what's going on to follow along with what is happening. That's what I feel like when I watched it, because there's so many glossed over bits. They kind of make you aware of certain characters and how they are, but yeah, I don't know. Conan was 5 MMO, if that's what it's going to be, it's nope for me. I mean, that was, what, 10 years ago or something like that? Conan was pretty good. I think the first book is fine to read. The books get a little wonky after that, for me. Especially when they include, like, the automaton creatures and planets and things like that. But, I mean, the premise is still there, right? Technology, bad. Worms, good. All right. I'm really intrigued in this, so I'll keep an eye on it. Lords of the Fallen. Checkers. Didn't we have...
After an age of the cruelest tyranny, man finally defeated its overlord. But gods do not fall forever.
Isn't this game already out?
The champions of war united and began the eternal watch over their tyrant's colossal remains. For some forces, even death.
It's a sequel, but it's just got a weird naming system. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. That's Fallen.
But now,
a while ago.
Eons later, the fallen god's influence pervades the world again, corrupting even sworn enemies. Join his accursed lords of the fallen and damn humanity.
It just looks exactly like Dark Souls, man. You know what I mean? This is how I felt about a lot of MMOs that were coming out about 10 years ago. It's like, it just looks exactly the same. And it's... I'm not saying it can't be as good, but it just feels like it's just the exact same game. Like, even these designs, the monster designs feel identical.
To a new age of devastation. Though from these darkest days, new heroes arise. To defy the gods, one must embrace the darkness. And so lies our only hope.
But it's Rocky.
Mother! Tell your children not to walk my word. Tell your children not to hear my word. What to mean, what to say. Mother,
I swear to God, if Jack shows up. My cool lamp. Praise be. Oh, lamp's dead. Oh, man. Yay! Praise lamp.
Fallen.
Yeah, I mean... It just looks exactly like Souls, but I can't get excited about it because I want a Souls game. I don't know, man. It's not tickling me at all. Now, this might, for the guys who made Detroit Become Human, because that was fucking hilarious, besides the bit where I had to walk away for a bit. Because, but never forget when we scienced what happens if you don't rescue the kid from being beaten. Ooh, whale friend.
We leave so many things behind us. Objects. Memories. Mistakes.
Our turtle friend.
They sink in time.
Any hippos?
Touch the bottom and go to sleep. Silence is full of ghosts. And here, voices can only come from the deep.
Ooh, ghosties.
Deep.
Spooky ghost.
Under the waves.
Well, yeah, I do want to check that out. Looks like it's going to be a walk simulator story, but could be excellent. We've had some fantastic ones in the last couple of years. The atmosphere looks really good, doesn't it? Yeah, I think this is worth a check out for sure. Have a little bit more. Hopefully you're not like, scavenging for snack bars. Looks like the whole world's underwater here. I mean, this is an underwater street, right? So is it going to be like Waterworld? That's a lighthouse. Was there anything on the surface before he went down? There's something over there. There's a building over there. So I'm guessing this is after the ice caps have melted. Well, there's an oil rig there. I wonder if that's a flashback to the past. Could be. Could be. All right, kind of curious about that one. The Lies of P. Oh, it's Timothy Chalamet. Carlo Collodi.
Can you hear me? I hope this reaches you. This city is falling apart. Chaos. Madness. Death. And there might be no going back.
Tifa?
But you can change that.
Oh, she's evil. Yep, she's Giga evil.
It depends on the choice you make. Truth.
Yep, knew it.
Or lie.
Cyberpunk Bloodborne?
I might be asking too much of you. But I don't have a choice.
Oh, there's a soul's life. What?
Only you can do this. Please.
Never trust a man in a bowler hat. Hell no. No,
finally,
fuck that guy.
We meet, son. The stage is set.
The light shines brightest in the darkest of times.
Oh, Jennifer.
All right, buddy, I'm here for you. Don't worry.
Oh, these monsters look cool. Alright, we appear to have a stamina bar.
No.
We've got a parry system. I've been on that bridge before. See, this looks more interesting to me compared to Lord of the Fallen. It's King Mechagon, baby! That guy looks way funny! Oh, that guy looks amazing. Oh, come on. That guy looks fantastic. He's got a little crown. He's got little bulbous hands. He's got wiggly fingers. That guy looks fantastic. Yeah, he's got the old jigglers. He's got a crown going. This guy looks amazing. Looks like Hellboy if you fell into a cyberpunk cosplay competition. Yeah, it really always comes down to the gameplay. It doesn't matter about the setting. Lies of P.
Destiny.
Oh, there's more going on here. Oh, Zeppler's in it. Now that girl gets around. Zeppler's the evil one? Oh, Piggy Man! Ha! Buckethead forever! Give me that glam. Maybe those are friends? Seems a bit dramatic.
Pop in the box, liar.
Pop in the box, liar. I'm definitely curious about that one. That looks alright, actually. It obviously depends on the gameplay. It looks cool. We got a dodge dash. Dodge dash.
Protect.
Yeah, that one looks interesting. That world setting could be really cool. It's about Pinocchio? Why is it about Pinocchio? I didn't see a big nose. Any noses? What, because of all the lies or what? It's about, because it's about lies. It's a bit of a stretch. There's a lot of things about lies. P means Pinocchio. They said it during the intro. Oh, okay. So you guys got told it was. There's nothing in the trailer that super indicates it's about Pinocchio. just that smart. Oh, Carlo Colodi. I didn't know he was the one who wrote it. I don't think I ever read Pinocchio. I think I only ever saw the movie. I don't know, something about that fucking puppet kid gave me the creeps, you know what I mean? Gave me the old creepers. The Expanse, oh, and this is not everybody wants me to, they're making a game of it. I haven't watched this yet. Oh, it's Telltale!
Drummer, his suit is punctured and losing pressure. You need to release the vault attached now or he could die.
Load him
up! Let's see what we can do.
Captain Drummer, what are your orders?
Didn't Telltale go bankrupt? I thought they were dissolved. Have they been didn't 2K close them down or something like that? But they survived. I thought they went belly up. They went bankrupt. They did, and then they got saved. Saved? Bob Ross?
The Expanse is obviously one of those universes that has a ton of opportunities to tell great stories. One of the things I'm super excited about is the zero-G stuff that we've been doing. A big part of when we're making the game, not only are we thinking about the characters, we also have to think about how can we evolve the genre in any way that will make players excited to be part of this universe and feel like they're engaging in something rather than just being a passive audience member.
You'll figure something out. I know you will.
Kill the kid.
It's actually been a really interesting thing as an actor to explore some of her more vulnerable sides that by the time we meet her in the series, they've been cauterized.
Because this score, drummer, this is the greatest score
I don't know anything about the Expanse.
Ever come across. You'll need me if you want any chance of unloading it.
I don't know. I have doubts about Telltale. They fucked up Game of Thrones. That's hard to do.
The craziness of an exploded ship that now constitutes several parts in a mass.
Why is everyone whispering?
Move them on. And balancing that out against almost like you're excavating a story. That's a personal story. Those are people, those are characters, and you are now among their ghosts. Whatever they were doing right before they died, being a scavenger, it's a pretty dark job. We're really excited about how it feels to both play and experience the story in the game.
It's more like a Telltale Dead Space.
So get to it.
I'm not watching the whole series to get context, though. That's not happening. There's no way. There's no way I'm watching the whole series. I'll give it a try. What's pre-alpha? Pre-alpha is the stuff that they're doing, like, tests of what they want scenes to look like and things like that, but it's not a playable game. That's what pre-alpha is. They've made, like, some scenes, some little sections, but it's not going through. It's very good. You'd like it. I know Fingal was trying to get me to watch it a million times because we were forcing ourselves to watch Star Trek Discovery all the time. Okay, this one looks like kind of exciting. From this is RPG, I assume. Word song. Okay, there's a good amount of names on there. From the industry veterans that brought you Fallout 3, New Vegas, Skyrim, Dragon Age Inquisition, Fallout 4, and The Outer Worlds. All right. Good name.
In the crux of reality, there exists two lies. One before the shadow, and one behind the eye.
Aye. Well, there's a lot we can derive from this. This gives us much to ponder, ladies and gentlemen. Begin the subreddit and engage in wild speculation from here. Take my money. That is the cock tease of the show. Yeah, a little bit. Okay, I guess we're potentially a long, long way from learning a bit more about Wordsong. But just letting you know, there's a game coming. It's got an eye and a shadow. Sometimes it's dark and sometimes it's light. And there's a man. There you go. There you go. That's good. The Phantom Hellcat. What's this? Bayonetta? Oh, she's edgy. Oh, with a Walkman? Another RPG? Wishlist it now? Why? Why would I wishlist this now? What possible reason would I have to wishlist this game? I need it. I need it based on these three clips. Feed the algorithm. Yeah, I hope there's not some investors like, on the basis of how many people wishlist this, will decide whether to fund the rest of your game. A trailer? This is not a trailer. This is like the modern teaser trailer stuff. Yeah, teaser. That's what I would say. Teaser. Teaser trailers. Alright, I mean, I'm not going to wishlist it right now. I'm sorry. I'm really genuinely sorry. From the bottom of my heart, I will not wishlist this right now. But maybe later. Maybe later. I will not do that. Are they all like... What's Outlast Trot? Is there an Outlast sequel? Another one? Oh, yeah. Oh, they're DLCs, man. Oh, the dentist is in it? Oh, no. Feel your control. I'll have to go some to beat Buddy. Buddy!
Pretty face.
If you've not played Outlast, all this is very commonplace.
Chemical encouragement, doctrine over person.
This is for your own good.
A final confession, elaborate and inclusive, rather than terse, for an even greater emphasis upon the experience of personal rebirth. The champion went out. Political criminals are subjected to a literally fatal dispensing of existence by the promise of execution.
What does that poster say? Hold on. Can you sign us up to this? Nope, so I'm definitely in. Let the miracles of science give you purpose, praise be. The world owes you everything. Men and women of any race, religion, class, or political persuasion. Stop by one of our convenient volunteer centers before the opportunity is gone forever. Murkoff Corp. Lost, lonely, poor, and confused. Well, that's me. That's me. I like the idea that they're going a dentist route with it. After the guy who was making all the... Chris. After the guy who was making all the... modifications to people in the last DLC. Is it multiplayer? Probably not. The Outlast series is not usually multiplayer. It might not be, but I like the idea they're going with the dentist route. That's kind of fucked up. I'm going to the dentist tomorrow. Yeah, it's hard to go where you go further than that, especially when that guy was going to saw your balls off. That was insane. Okay, Monkey Island.
Hello, friends. It's your old pal, Stan.
Hi, Stan.
Coming to you through the magic of marketing to let
Where's
you
Murray?
Know that your search for quality entertainment is about to bear fruit. But I wouldn't be doing my job if I just dropped the details on you without a little buildup. I want you to see the kind of fine dining establishments you'll be visiting, like this one.
Get lost.
And if escapism is your cup of flavor, you can't do much better than this exotic and extremely remote island.
Stay back! How did you find me?
Return to Monkey Island launches September 19th, which happens to be International Talk Like a Pirate Day. But you don't have to wait. You can order it right now, before it's even out. Something we in the marketing industry call a pre-order. As a bonus, I'm ready to unload this shipment of beautiful horse armor to anyone who pre-orders Return to Monkey Island. It'll look fantastic in your inventory.
Oi, you missed a spot.
I've got to go now. I've got a lot of irons and a lot of fires. You know how it is. But I'll be back to steal every scene I'm in Return to Monkey Island. I'll see you there.
I will see you there.
All pre-order customers will receive the exclusive horse armor item in their inventory. Please note that the horse armor has no practical use in-game and in no way will contribute to the gameplay, puzzles, or narrative of Return to Monkey Island.
It's on Switch and PC. Okay, I mean, I'm definitely down. I'm definitely down. Is it on Steam? We need to check, don't we? We need to check. So it's 20. You do get the horse armor. Totally getting it. It's out in September. Oh, that's fantastic. I'm very much looking forward to that. We're doing that full blind, by the way. I don't care how long we get stuck on whatever puzzle it is. I'm not asked. We're going full blind. If we're there once again for like 2 hours stuck on the same puzzle, trying everything, I don't care if you know the answer. We're doing it. We're figuring it out. Blacktail. A lot of masks in the upcoming games.
Once upon a time, there were two twin sisters,
Aloy and Aloy,
and Yaga.
You got it all wrong. What? Once upon a time, there was a freak with no face.
Stop it!
You can't hide from Baba, Princess.
Oh, Wrigleyum!
How much longer you want to be a nobody?
I just need to find the Red Oak.
What you really want to find is...
Explore a mythical world like no other.
What the hell is wrong with this forest?
We're a witch!
Not bad. You kill it. You kill it again.
If anything bad happens, always head straight to the Red Oak.
Okay, I'm down. Will I become the... Look at the interesting little sprite graphics they did. Those little 8-bits. Will we be the good or the bad witch? Baba Yaga's not that scary. It's only Keanu Reeves. It's not that bad. Yeah, Blacktail looks kind of interesting. Actually has a little bit of gameplay in this. Bad witch. Is everyone going to go bad witch? Morally grey witch. Oh, no. The last one. This is the last one that Bex showed us here.
And I think you're going to get pretty excited about it. Check out this world premiere.
Okay. Oh, man, what a horrendously ugly woman. Textured face. As a man, I'm offended. I am offended. As we all know, every woman in existence has a perfectly smooth face. And this just upsets me. Pause. Can you believe it? Pause. Pause. Ugh. Vomit worthy. Unbelievable.
The sand has memories. Memories of our past. When gods walked this world, and our heroes stood amongst them. But the gods' vanity grew, and in their struggle, we were cast away. Only remnants of these stories remain. In the sand. In the ruins of this shattered, broken world.
That's gotta be hot, dude. Right? What is this, Prince of Persia? Piece of repair, man. It's a braggart simulator. Give the man a broom.
Even in ruins, we endure. We won't let go.
We're paying attention to your bridge.
For now, we can stand for ourselves. And face gods.
Atlas Fall. Oh, it is co-op. Wishlisting now. What emphasis is this on wishlisting shit? What the fuck? Are they actually basing decisions on wishlisting shit? Looks pretty solid, yeah. I don't think I can play this with Nups. That's probably unacceptable. Because he's just gonna fucking... You know what I mean? He's gonna sweat it out. He's gonna sweat the shit out of it. It boosts visibility on Steam. Must do, I guess. Been a thing for a while. I don't think I've wishlisted any game ever. I don't think so. I don't think I've ever done it. Well, that one I'm definitely interested in. I think my favorites that have been announced so far from the sweatbox that is Gamescom. Monkey Island, obviously. Like, that's 100% we're playing that. Lies of P. I'm going to keep an eye on it. Not 100% we'll play that, but I'm definitely intrigued. Outlast, yes. We'll definitely check out Outlast. And I we'll find out what's going on with the Dune game. If it's, as I suspect, or as I hope, it's an MMO set during from the perspective of the Fremen, only that would be really interesting. Will remain. What they mean by open world survival MMO, though, if it's got to be like Rust, that's going to be a little awkward. Life's also a good trailer, but I'm sure it's something for you. Probably, maybe not, if she digs it out. New Tales from the Borderlands. We saw the games we just looked at. Dune Awakening, Lords of the Fallen. I have no interest in Lords of the Fallen, unfortunately. If it's surprisingly good. Oh, yes. Under the Waves, I'm interested in as well.
The Deep.
Under the Waves, I think it's probably a one-stream kind of game, which should be really fun. A nice, good story. The Expanse. I don't know enough about The Expanse, the Telltale one. Phantom Hellcat, obviously I'm wishlisting it. They showed a screenshot of the game. That's enough for me. I'm sold. What was Blacktail again? Oh, the Sisters. Yeah, I'm kind of down to see what's going on with the Witch Sisters. Yeah, the Witch Sisters. I'm kind of down for that as well. So, yeah, Baba Yaga. Baba Yaga. The Callisto Protocol. Not got that. That's not in my list here. The Callisto Protocol? But Peggy 18. I don't know. I don't watch The Expanse. That's about as far as I got, Chris. Okay, this looks highly... Oh, this is the Dead Space people. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I do know about this. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Who built this machine? Like, that is a health and safety fucking nightmare.
That doesn't conform to OSHA.
Right, that is just an absolute disgrace.
Like, that railing's maybe like 6 inches. Over it. Like, it's not... You'd be better off without it.
I mean, look at all the ridges and shit on it. Like, it's just chilling in the middle of the room. Look at that! Look at the state of this device that somebody built. There's a video of the top 10 worst environmental machines in video games. And it's just like the most stupid things that have existed in video games to make a cool moment, like throwing somebody into a meat grinder where they've just like stuck this disastrous machine. We could do top 10 health and safety violations in video games.
Yes.
That's probably a really funny video. Uh-huh. I don't like this gameplay. I assume you do not have to be this slow. Why did you throw him into the machine? You're wasting ammo! Killing my... Now you're gonna do it? Never gonna get those bullets back. This guy's well shit. Well, I do love constantly regenerating enemies. This fucking guy. Why would you show a gameplay trailer of someone being absolute arse at the game? That's so infuriating. Like, there has to be a better gameplay loop you can show than someone being total dog shit at your game.
Pressure check. Releasing gate now. Releasing gate now.
Anybody else think that was going to be a crocodile? Any Resident Evil lovers out there? I thought it's going to be a crocodile. It's a really big drainage tunnel. Awful. Fucking why? Why does this exist? Who built this? Why would that exist in the water management tunnel? It's the water grinder and it's completely ineffective. It's on the roof. It's the most ineffective device of all time. Okay, so we need a thing, right? Let's suppose our enormous, absolutely enormous water tunnel gets full of water. Then we need to grind the top 20% of the water. Just this little bit, though, because it doesn't meet and doesn't actually grind anything. It just spins. Oh, spooder eggs. Spooder eggs. It's a sewer to break up shit. No, no, no. That's what they want you to think. But that doesn't make any sense. Because if that's what its purpose was, it would be on the bottom. And it would also meet. Don't fall for their lies. It's not a grinder for sewage. It's banned. Let's back up your theory again about the sewage grinder. So we just put a fan that goes through the sewage as well and picks up shit as it spins. Does that meet your criteria of trying to justify this device? Does it? No. Thank God. I'm happy you're dead. I bet you're the health and safety manager. I'm glad he's dead, honestly. If he's the engineer who built this place, he deserves to die. That's horrendous. That really put me off. God damn it, I was kind of excited for this game, but this gameplay trailer has really ruined it for me. Son of a bitch. I hate when that happens. Wishlist it. Match wishlist it. Basically, all you do in the game is water slides and bad combat. I was looking at it, like, I'm looking at if it's the new Dead Space. They don't seem to have come off of some sort of way of defeating the enemies. Like, in Dead Space, it was about removing limbs. Right? That was the trick, is you had to remove the limbs. These look like they just regenerate, unless... I can't see, like, a noticeable weak spot on legs or anything. He takes the head off, and the head just grows back. So either these are like them Resident Evil 2 monsters that just constantly regenerate unless you burn them or grind them into dust. In which case, why would you show that in your trailer? Because it's really irritating. Those enemies are not fun. I'm so confused by this whole trailer. This is terrible. Yeah, like why would you put the constantly regenerating ones in here? To show you can use the environment, but you showed that in the first 2 seconds, right? That was the first thing the guy did. Yeah, here. Right, you've shown you can use the environment. Done. Then you show other things. The dev said it's definitely not a Dead Space successor. No, it's not. This looks terrible. I'm really upset about this because I was kind of looking forward to a Dead Space successor, but this has not done itself any favors. No, 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 no! How long was the slide section? 2 minutes, the cutscene starts. Yeah, it's a full minute of sliding down a water slide. Whee! Is he? I think he is controlling this to avoid the pillars. Somewhat controlling it, unless this is just a cutscene to death. If this is gameplay, how would we avoid dying? Is it just because he hit the fan? It is, right? He just hit the fan blade. I actually call shenanigans on this. It looks like he was going... I don't know. He looks pretty safe to me. No, I call shenanigans. He moved into it. I call shenanigans. He looked fine to me. He looked fine to me. I call shenanigans on that. He leaned in. He aimed for the blade. That's the only series of the game. You just die in a fan. 15 hours of adventure. But along with that, though, there were some really cool things that came out of that. That was good. On my screen, he was dead. Oh, yeah, for sure. He got snapshotted. Oh, bummer. That dude should learn to slide cast. Get his slide cast on. Well, yeah. All right. So a good, like, 6 games came out of that, though. They were pretty good. The Dune Awakening, want to know more. Under the Waves, we'll check out. Lies of P, we'll check out. Outlast, yes. Monkey Island, yes. Blacktail. Atlas Falling, I don't know. What's the vibe we're getting on Atlas Falling? This, like, co-op, sand, and I think you're Prince gonna get of Persia excited. Stuff.
The remnants of these.
Seems okay. Doesn't seem to have anything special about it to me. That's what I'm thinking, Chris. It seems very generic. Kind of cool that you can have random zombies. Gameplay was towards the end.
In ruins, we endure. We won't let go.
Oh, is it for the people who made the surge?
For now, we can stand for ourselves.
It was like the last 20 seconds or something was gameplay. Very flashy. Woo! Wishlist it. Right, first things first here. We need to pre-order Monkey Island for our horse armor. Right? That's got to be objective number one. That has to be. We can't live in a world where we don't have horse armor just sat in our inventory for no reason. Important that we sort that out. Let's get that done. crucial. It's crucial that we do that. Hold on. I'm not wishlisting it. I'm actually buying it. I'm making a purchase. Purchase. Thank you for your purchase. We did it. We did it. We got it, guys. Horse armor is confirmed. We have horse armor. Fantastic.